everyone and welcome back to my channel. Today we are in fact not doing a cottage, which I know, shocking. We've been doing so many cottages lately, both before like pre-hype we did two cottages, and then when Cottage Living came out we done like two cottages, one farmhouse and a tavern. So we've been doing a lot of the Cottage Living vibe stuff. So I thought it was time to change that up and do something a little bit different. Of course, I love doing cottages and I will definitely do more cottages in the future, but for right now I think it's time to move on. So today we are making a Japanese restaurant, which I haven't played with dine out in so long. So when I was actually doing the menu for this restaurant, it was so much new stuff and it's kind of exciting, even though, and I really hope that they do an overhaul of the dine out game pack, because it is a really good game pack. And I think they talked on stream, I wasn't on stream that day so I don't know exactly, but I'm pretty sure that they said that they were gonna do like an overhaul of the packs. So hopefully Dine Out gets the overhaul that it deserves, because I think it would be a really good pack if it wasn't so messy, I guess. But we are doing a build in Mankamura Bay today, a Japanese restaurant, which I really wanted to do for a long time. I think the first time I started planning to do this restaurant was like maybe a little over 2 months ago, but then so much things came up, like Dream Home Decorator came out, and then I had some other builds I wanted to do, and then we got so close to Cottage Living, so I wanted to hide that, and then of course doing builds for Cottage Living. So this build really just got pushed back so much, and I honestly, I completely forgot that I wanted to do it. And then I went through like my video like ideas and I was like, oh yeah, you're right, I wanted to do a Japanese restaurant. So that is what we're doing today. And this restaurant actually ended up looking quite different from what I had originally planned, but I think it really ended up looking really nice anyway, and I really like the kind of style of it. Of course, now with the Cottage Living update and yeah, the patch for Cottage Living, we got the pond hall, which is amazing, and I think that the pond really looks nice at this restaurant, and I think it really like fits in. And I think it's really nice that you can kind of sit outside and look over the pond, and there's like swans and ducks in there, and it's just really really like natural and nice and beautiful, especially at night. And I really really like how this ended up looking. And this build is actually only Base Game, Dine Out and Snow Escape. I was like, what is it called again? Snow Escape. And because I really wanted it to be like usable for you guys, so that it wouldn't be like a million packs, but still of course using the packs that I need to use. And I didn't really feel super limited by that. Like there was never like a time when I was like, oh, I really want to use this thing but it's from another pack. I think that it was really easy for me to do this restaurant with that pack limitation, and I didn't really feel limited like I said, so it went really nicely. And I did this in like record time. I think this took me maybe a little 2 hours to do everything, which for me is really quickly. I usually take like 5 hours to make a build, and this took like 2 hours. I was like, whoa, speed build, what's happening here? I'm never this fast, but I guess that I just got into that flow. And then here we have this kind of like, I don't really remember what you call them, but it's not a visual, it's something else, but I think it's really, it's like part of the Japanese culture, and I think it's really fit in here, so I put it in here. And then we also have some benches in here that you seem to sit at. Maybe it would be nice to have like, if you're on a date, to just sit a little bit alone. I don't think that the guests would go there by themselves, but you know, if you're on a date with some Sims, that maybe they will be wanting to sit a little bit by themselves, and then they can be out there. And then I ended up putting plants on top of the like outside area, which I usually do that with the Island Living plants that we have, but of course I didn't have access to Island Living, so I used some Base Game ones. And I'm not quite sure if I'm 100% like into that, because it looks nice, but also like I like it, but I'm also not sure if I should have kept it. But I think it ended up looking like nice anyway. I guess it's kind of like a protection and like an extra detail, and I guess it's nice. I don't know. But moving on to the interior, I really wanted to use a lot of Mankamura Bay. No, Snow Escape. I keep wanting to call this pack Mankamura Bay, but it's called Snow Escape. I used a lot of the Snow Escape stuff, of course, to keep the kind of Japanese vibe. And I think I ended up putting in But counting both inside and outside, I used about 9 tables, I think. I think that the table layout changes a couple of times. I also ended up putting in like a fireplace in here and some like shelving and stuff. And I think it ended up looking really cute. I did kind of struggle with the decorating for a while because I really wanted to keep it like kind of like Japanese, but also I guess I struggled to get the kind of vibe that I wanted. But I think that in the end it ended up looking really nice. And then I ended up putting in this little like lower like Japanese table. I don't know what you call them, but the one that's up on the platform, which I don't think that your Sims will get seated there like automatically. Like if you go at a table, I don't think that they will seat you there. But I did put a hot pot on there, so I guess that technically you could, if you do it yourself, your Sims can eat up there. But I don't think that you will be seated there because of it's like a different type of table. Because I was here with my Sim and no one got seated up there, which might have been like, oh, we didn't have enough Sims to seat them up there, or what I would think is more likely that it doesn't work at those tables because, well, number one, it's a different type of table, but also, of course, Snow Escape came out before or after, way after Dying Out, so maybe it's just not been incorporated. Which is something, if they're gonna do an overhaul of this pack, I would really like to see that we would be able to see Sims at those tables, because I think it would be really nice. And yeah, but I think that it was just like a nice detail to have in here. And then I ended up putting the paintings actually underneath the windows, because the windows are so high up. Like, this is the medium wall height, I believe. And I did end up putting the windows high up because of how the paneling looks on the outside, which means that the paintings have to go underneath them, but I think it's kind of like a cool detail. And then I ended up putting in curtains where the platform is, and I think it was a really nice detail. I think it's really like a simple way to really put in more detail is to put in those curtains, and I think it looked really nice. And then I sliced up this rug from Snow Escape, which ended up changing color a couple of times, but I think it ended up looking really nice anyway. I don't know how realistic it is to have rugs at a restaurant. I don't think that is something that you usually see. I don't know, at least, I guess I've never thought of it, but I don't think you usually have rugs at restaurants because I guess it's kind of like the spill factor, the thing with having a lot of food and stuff. But I think that a rug really looks nice and it really fills up a space. Like, if you have a space that feels kind of empty, a rug can really help. So I ended up putting a rug in here. I think it looks more homey and more like cozy, which is kind of the vibe that I wanted. And I think it looks really nice. And it's the Sims, so it doesn't really matter, right? Now I put in the fireplace in here. And I think that this looks really nice with the fireplace. It's a nice little detail. I really just wanted to make sure that this place wasn't boring, or like, I wanted it to be like visually interesting, which is something that I usually talk about, that I want my builds to be visually interesting. Like, you want to have like this, just this, I guess you just want it to be nice to look at, which is not too much to ask for, I guess. And then, but I did really struggle with adding in this little like small details like clutter and like that kind of stuff, because I guess we had kind of limited clutter with the packs that I chose. Like, I would have thought that Dine Out would have come with more like dining stuff, and maybe it did, but it didn't really fit with this kind of Japanese style that I was going for. And then the Japanese stuff didn't have too much like dining stuff, so it's like I did struggle with the like small details, but I think it ended up looking really nice anyway. And then I did end up putting a shelf over there where the bathrooms are, which has two things on it. It has plates, and then it has this weird like feather thing that you write with, because nothing places on shelves, especially not with these packs that I had. Like, nothing places on shelves, so there was a very empty shelf, but I just wanted the detail of the shelf, but I didn't have anything to actually put on there, which is kind of funny, I guess. And then I did the kitchen, which your Sims don't need any of these things at all to run a restaurant. You literally just need the like the cooking station and the waiter station to have a functional kitchen. But I thought it would be boring to just have, like, your Sims don't need a dishwasher, your Sims don't need a fridge, your Sims don't need any of this stuff. But it looks nicer, and it's nicer to have like a full kitchen instead of just having like what your Sims need to have, because this is kind of boring. You know, you want it to be decorated and nice and have those kind of milk jugs and boxes with food and that wine thing, which I don't trust it at all. It used to like the, just the neck of the bottle that's kind of attached to this thing, and I would feel like the bottles would just fall out. Like, I don't trust that at all. I wouldn't trust to have my wine bottles in that, but it looks nice, I guess. And then I struggled with putting in plants, but I really like this down-out plant that I put in, which I never use that normally. I guess it just kind of disappears into the, like, plant category, especially when you have all the pegs on. It's like a lot of things disappears because you have so much stuff, and it just kind of becomes, it just disappears into the void, I guess. But then when you have your limited packs, you really get to use those stuff that you normally wouldn't use. But like that down-out plant is so pretty, and I kind of have to keep that in mind that it exists because I really want to use it more. And then I did the bathrooms, which are pretty much identical, and they're not too fancy. It's just like a toilet with a sink and then like a trash can, which is all you really need. It's like a very simple bathroom, and it really doesn't need to be more than that. But then I'm just going around and adding a few more details. I think I'm about done. I'm doing this outside area, which I talked about earlier, that I thought that maybe you can go here with your date if you want to be more alone. I originally wanted to have like a little like grilling area, like where you could put a fire, but we didn't have that with any of the packs that I used, so I just ended up putting this space game table in here, which I thought looks really cute anyway. And here with this window shutters, I accidentally put one window shutter too high up, and I didn't notice it, so one of them is higher up than the others, which, so yeah, but just keep that in mind. But yeah, so we are about to jump into screenshots, so if you enjoyed this video, make sure to like and subscribe, and I will see you all very very soon. Ripley out. Hoodie, I'm a perfect 10. Whoa.